Kabare Gane, Mahindugu Nagada. This is your elder, Mahinduga, General Abu Amin Ra. My brothers and sisters, I'm coming before you at this particular time, hopefully, to stimulate your thinking process and to move your thinking into a critical thinking level where you can understand what I'm talking about and realize I'm just contacting your knowledge bank, the knowledge that's already there, and making you aware of it. Listen, my brothers and sisters, something big appears to be getting ready to go down in the Western world. Now listen to this. There are three major religions that are operating within the Western world. Those religions are called the Abrahamic faiths. The first one is Judaism. The second one is Christianity. And the third one is Islam. Now, this will either make you or break you. This is going to put your religions to the test. Because in your Bible that informed you all, God speaks to Abraham, supposedly, and tells him, know for a surety, your descendants are going to be the servants and the slaves of a foreign people. And they're going to take them into slavery. Then later on, Bible has God saying, because you disobeyed my word, because you disobeyed the laws that I have established for you, I'm going to send you into Egypt again by way of ships. There you will serve them for 400 years. Years in a strange land. Now, God is supposedly talking about the new Egypt. Egypt being assembled in the Christian faith, Judaic faith, and the Islamic faith. As that which must save us, the law, the promises of Abraham and God. So 400 years, I just want to say, if the Bible, the Torah, or any other religious book claims, prophesizes, states emphatically that they're going to be brought into a new Egypt. Egypt being a symbol for pain and suffering, even though it was not. That's what the outsiders experienced it as being. But anyhow, back to the main thrust of this short talk here. We were brought here in ships in the United States of America in 1619. And 400 years will be up next year. If it's not, throw your religious books based on the Abrahamic faith in the lake. because they are false. In order for them to be legitimate, they must evidence what they promise will occur in 2019. I'm not throwing them in the trash pile. So since white people are the Christians of the world, they are also the Jews, the so-called Jews of the world. And they believe in their religious books. Some of them somehow are full of fear today because 1619 is approaching and they know something is going to go down. 40 years will be up next year. So, now could this rigmarole about what's going on with the people in Latin America and the children being separated from their mothers is all about? It's just a distraction. Trying to distract them so that they can gather more comrades, let more whites in than blacks in or browns in, because they want to stay in power, but they're decreasing in numbers. So they're going to keep the Latin Americans out of here, and they're going to keep black people out of here, and they're going to kill those who are here at present. They must survive. They must be the dominating people within these confines we find ourselves in, called the United Snakes of America. Hope you get the gist of what I'm saying, even though I'm rambling all over the place today. I'm rambling because it appears to be a game, a distraction. All this hoogamaroo, man. They didn't have to put all this stuff out in the open. They know what they're going to do. They didn't have to do it that way. They're trying to draw your attention to it because they are fearful that 2019 will come to pass. So my brothers and sisters, I say, I hope you understand this message I'm attempting to bring to you. Once again, peace and hope to you, my endeavor, na-da-da.